Sky now for a check of your Sunday forecast.
Talitha, thank you. I've got some clouds in place over Elon University today, a quiet campus here in the early going, but skies are starting to brighten up in the early going today. We go to the satellite, and you can see in the last few hours during the overnight that we had a heavy cloud deck start to roll in. There is some moisture in the back edge of this coming through Tennessee that will make a run at our mountains later this morning through around midday, and the earlier it gets there, the better chance for a few flakes mixing in. South winds already taking hold should make this a transition to rain at worst, but again, mostly a few raindrops and certainly inconsequential as it isn't a lot of moisture coming in. There is some front to our north. It'll start to descend southward. It has snow along the boundary, but most of that will pass us to the north. As that front gets through, it will bring us at least a chance tomorrow for a passing shower or maybe even a little light snow in the mountains. But a complicated forecast coming our way. We'll start with a close-up view of Futurecast. Temperatures are primarily in the 40s to near 50 by midday. Notice the clearing that's ongoing as we go into the early afternoon. I think we have a good amount of sunshine for a while today, right around peak heating, and then this evening we'll start to see those clouds rolling back in. The front does get by us tonight into tomorrow. Mostly dry, but it'll play a catch-up with some moisture heading into Tuesday. I'll explain that in a moment. Temperatures 33 degrees over a good chunk of the area today. We're mostly above freezing and will likely stay that way today. Randleman to Stoneville, a high of 57. Southwest winds at 10 to 20 miles per hour during the afternoon. Cool start from Dobson to North Wilkesboro with a high of 54 degrees today. And looking at McGrady, Sparta, Independence, temperatures in the 30s for the majority of the day, but should creep into the 40s. Any chance for wet or wintry weather early on will end as rain, mainly during the afternoon. And again, not a big chance for that. All right, we pick things up tomorrow around lunchtime. The front has gotten through at this point. There isn't a lot of action along that, but noticeably we have some wet weather starting to pop up. There is quite a bit of energy moving along the front that'll spark some rain to the south and snow to the north of that. Now, the latest model runs put it in the Charlotte and the Asheville metro areas down to Columbia early Tuesday, and we could just see some of that getting into our southernmost communities during the daytime hours on Tuesday. Where that front stalls will have a big impact on who sees that and who doesn't. We could get shut out entirely. We could get a little light snow from that. Some of the models show a little light snow in our area, an inch or two, but heading into Wednesday and Thursday, the European model has been bullish with another more powerful winter storm system hitting us Wednesday and Wednesday night that could bring all kinds of snow into the area. This is an unlikely scenario right now. There's still a ton of uncertainty of whether the storm will develop at all and where it will go once it does. So for right now, we're talking for today, a passing shower, mainly rain north and west of us. Monday, a mostly dry front easing through the area, and then it gets more interesting Tuesday, Wednesday, even into early Thursday with big storm potential or nothing at all. Chances are we'll see a little bit of a hybrid with a rain-snow mix in our area, which would really cut back on totals. But stay with us. There's still a lot of uncertainty with us, especially midweek onward, but it will cool down and raise the threat at least for a little light snow in our area, especially on Tuesday.